All right, so this is a computer we already have BetterCap installed on. So just showing you the version that we're on, just so we're on a level playing field.
It can
And
be
then,
installed on Mac as well as Kali.
right, so and then I'm just doing a little helper argument so you can kind of see what's built in by default. And then we go ahead and run our first command, which I believe is just the BetterCap app by default. So this will.
All it really does is it shows you all the computers on the network. It'll give you their name, IP, and then you can take that IP and reference it to their MAC address up above.
So as this shuts down, because we should have a little
No.
click.
Nice, nice.
Let's see what's coming up next to get through. We'll cut it to like right there. So where it like highlights
Nice.
that we're doing that. All right, so this next command is the sniffer command, which will track all packets on the network. So if you don't designate a target, it actually just catches and displays all packets going throughout the entire network.
Now, this isn't running the SSL stripper that we'll show you later, which means all the packets we receive are going to be encrypted. So we can only see the web address they're going to and what machine it's doing, not any more information. But later on, we're going to show you a way in which we can get past that and actually get the information in plain text that's coming from those web pages.
All right, so this next command is one that actually will allow us to run the SSL stripper and see the in plain text, the username and password for certain accounts. We've tried it on multiple, not all work, but we're just giving you an example of one that does work. And it is OSU or higher OSU grads, which is kind of surprising. I tried it on a few different ones. Indeed works, Fitbit works, so like Fitbit's website, and surprisingly enough, AT&T.net's website works, which is kind of ironic.
It'll also get some data from apps, depending on the app. Some apps work and some apps don't, but they register a little different than the web pages, so sometimes the program has issues picking it up. But the web pages do work on iPhones and mobile devices.
Just cut that out right there. It should cut to a part where it starts happening. So here in a second at the bottom of the page, you'll be able to see just username and password straight up, test and password. So with insecure sites, it will show any login and from credentials, just plain text like that.
The program automatically identifies exactly where you're entering the information and pulls in, shows you very easily. It makes it so any kind of script kiddie can pull this thing up, run it, and figure out what somebody's username and password are.
So this next command actually runs a script from our computer. It sets our interface device, what type of attack we want to do, the location of the script on the computer, and the location of the picture, and in between the proxy and the victim, it actually replaces images. Here, as you can see, where we're highlighting, it actually lets you know what you are or when it is attacking the victim.
So here's an example of the script actually running on the page. It went and replaced any file that was labeled as a dot image, JPEG, or any other image file type, and replaced it to the file path that we located on our computer through that Ruby script. On this example, we actually used a page that has HTTP, but it works with the SSL stripping that we used earlier, and you could use this example on a page that has HTTPS. So here's another example of us running a Ruby script through BetterCap. In this example, we have a script that causes a div to be placed over the entire page that makes it not clickable, but it runs in a lot of the same ways that that image file happens.
So what happened at the beginning of that video is you could see that we could highlight text on the page and even click on links, but now once you refresh the page and the script has been applied, you can't actually click on anything.